We're spotlighting some of the powers and responsibilities the first ever elected mayor for West Yorkshire will have ahead of the big ballot next Thursday. It's a big job. The mayor will be handling budgets, lobbying for extra investment for things like transport, regeneration, skills, adult education, policing. They'll also be overseeing housing, for example, helping decide where and how many new homes need to be built and how to boost social and affordable housing. Aisha Iqbal has been talking to one woman in Bradford who survived her own personal housing crisis and who now has a message for the mayoral hopefuls.
Normally people in my position, they struggle to get housing. You know, there's not enough housing around.
It's been a traumatic year for Mum Deborah and her young family, forced to leave her rented home as it started to crumble around her. And after pleas to the landlord went unheard, she and her children ended up living in a hostel for 6 months.
With having no available funds in the bank, we were struggling. I have got children with health conditions and I'm not able to work. But I also have a younger son that has a renal condition. He's going to be looking at a transplant somewhere down the line. It's so difficult to get into the private rented sector. And at the minute, there is just a lack of housing in general for people in my position. It just felt like a godsend that we were offered this property from Manningham Housing.
With the help of the Bradford-based Housing Association, the family are finally settled into a new home. But Deborah's experience is not a unique one, and she knows she's one of the lucky ones. How bad is the housing crisis, do you think, in this country?
Awful. It's really, really bad.
Where would you have been had you not managed to get this house?
We could have ended up in another really bad private rental, or we could have still been in the hostel.
Was there ever a fear of being completely homeless and being on the street?
Yeah, that fear was quite big. We didn't know how long we'd be able to stay in the hostel, and we were desperately trying to find somewhere else.
And if you need any help, just ring the office.
Well, I've got to ring occupational therapy.
Once you sort yourself out, let us know. We'll do what we can.
Hello, I'm Abdul Rivat from Manningham Housing Association. I'm Vice Chair.
Tell me how you came across Deborah and her family and how you were able to help them.
Well, our housing team actually contacted me about Deborah's family and her particular circumstances.
How important is expanding on and improving the social housing market in solving the wider housing crisis?
Well, the reality of the situation is that most people cannot get on the housing market. So young people cannot get onto the property ladder. They're stuck, you know, in private rented accommodation or with family and friends. It means older people don't have access to the right type of accommodation to meet their needs. And if they would free up some of that stock, that will open up opportunities for existing families. And ultimately, you know, we're not building enough as a country. You know, we need to get a grip of that.
We're talking about the mayor coming up. They're going to have some powers around, potentially around planning, about where to build houses, how many houses to build, and what types of houses to build. What would you like to say to them?
There's just not enough available housing, affordable housing either. They need to make it easier for families with young children, families on, not necessarily just on benefits, but families that are working but on a low income, to get on the property ladder one way or the other. I actually used to own my own property years ago that I'd bought off Bradford Council that I got the right to buy. I ended up having to sell it many years ago because it was too small. But now I don't feel like I could ever afford to buy my own house. But if I could stay, you know, in somewhere like this, I'd be happy.
Is there a panacea solution to this?
Well, I think there's a lot said about, oh, we've got to encroach on the green belt. I think there is capacity in terms of planning permissions. There is capacity in terms of existing sites that could be brought forward, whether it's in the hands of the public sector or whether in the hands of others. So where there are schemes which aren't going to work in favour of localities, I think the mayor should call those sites in and review them and consider the common good.
What do you want to say to Abdul and to his team?
Thank you so much for taking us on. I hate to think where we could have ended up, you know, after all the nightmares that we've had in the past. Well, this is life-saving. This is life-changing for us. I like having my own front door. I like having my own bedroom again.
Aisha Iqbal with that report. Aisha's with us right now, in fact. I think probably we got the gist there of why this is such an important issue for the candidates. But what do they have to say? What are their priorities around housing, Aisha?
Morning, Richard. The first thing to note, interestingly, the government has actually temporarily blocked the planning powers, which were expected to be handed to our new West Yorkshire mayor due to this ongoing change to the planning system that they're trying to implement. But it will eventually be something that's a huge part of what they do. And when those powers are unlocked, it's definitely more an if than a when than an if scenario. And across the border, over the Pennines in Manchester, for example, you know, it has worked in the West Midlands as well. The mayor there's implemented what he calls is a house building revolution. So it can work and will work. Now, Labour's Tracy Brabin, she is one of the candidates. She says she wants to build 5,000 sustainable homes, including council houses and affordable homes. And she says that someone who grew up in a council flat herself, she really does understand the value of social housing. For the Greens, Andrew Cooper is their hopeful, and he wants to create a green building fund and to ensure all new build public buildings and social housing projects are energy efficient. And he also wants powers from the government to suspend the right to buy council housing, he says, to protect council housing from private speculators. We've also got the Conservative candidate Matt Robinson. He says he wants to fight to protect the green belt and expand on building on brownfield sites. That's things like old factory sites and demolished sites, and basically build new homes first on these sites. And he also wants to do more to put green technology in existing homes as well as new ones. The English Democrat candidate, Richard, is Therese Hurst. She also wants to build 5,000 new affordable, sustainable homes. And she says she wants to work with housing associations more. The Yorkshire Party candidate, Bob Buxton, also very passionate about protecting the green belt and on building on floodplains and sports fields is something that he wants to curtail, really. And he also says that new developments should use brownfield sites first. Waj Ali is a Reform Party candidate. He wants to build 10,000 affordable and sustainable social homes and also wants to give priority to victims of domestic abuse and offer help for the homeless as part of these schemes. And finally, Stuart Galton is the Lib Dem candidate, and he says actually the first thing the West Yorkshire mayor should do is challenge the government to actually give the West Yorkshire mayor the powers to make a difference now rather than later. And he says the blocking of these powers means the government has made it easy for developers to build the kind of housing they want rather than what's actually needed. And you can read more on each of the candidates' policy pledges on housing and other areas if you go to the BBC's website. Just find the Leeds and West Yorkshire homepage.
Aisha, thank you. Same time tomorrow, different issue.